7654321.
You'll never have the sacred stone.
Oh, this you crazy mother.
Welcome to Ride Shine Detailing. Welcome to a new Ride My Vlog. Sorry, the vlogs are taking a bit longer, but it's very busy here at Ride Shine. We have to do a lot of big projects. It takes all of my attention, all of my time, so I don't have time to edit my videos. I have all the footage, I have all the video, but I don't have time to edit it. Doesn't matter, you know, well, for you guys, because you want to see a new video, but I have all the footage, so it's going to be in the next vlogs. Don't worry, only give me some time to make them. I know on YouTube you have to be really consequent with uploading videos. I know, and we're working on it to do it more regularly. But you know, the Ride and Shine is like me and my wife, and sometimes I have a little bit help. And well, you can't do all the things by yourself. Otherwise, I'm going to be in the mental institution at the end of this year. But you know, just follow us. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and you'll get a notification when a new video is uploaded and you'll see everything what we do here at Ride and Shine. So we're also working on this Porsche GT3. Very nice car. We already installed PPF on the whole front of the car. We have to do some more sections like the side skirts and some other parts, and then she will be covered with PPF on the very sensitive parts, the impact areas. And then I'm going to prepare this car for a full installation of IAMO, Mayvinci IAMO ceramic coating, and also the wheels are going to be protected with wheel guard, and then this car can go on the road this weekend. The owner is going to drive, I think, a rally or a tour drive, I don't know, but when he is behind another car and the stones are just going into the air and hitting the car, then he's going to be protected. You never are going to miss out on a stone chip with a rally, and well, I think you should be happy when it's on. If this was my car, I really hate it when there was one stone chip on the front bumper. Well, we did a lot of other cars lately, and I'm going to put them in the video right now. Just watch the end results, watch what we did, and have fun with it, and I will see you guys at the end of the video.
Together, together.
Covered the floor before I'm going to clean the wheel arches. Also here my car lift is covered. The cars need to be in perfect shape, but I also want to keep my appliances in perfect shape. So let's begin cleaning the wheel arches. Here we see the wheel arches of the Porsche. Let's see what we can make of this. Quite dirty, but hey, it's also an old car. So let's clean this and then I will show you the difference.
Crystal skies, crowded places, lonely faces, howling winds. Desperation, hesitation for the wind, running from the darkness of the night. We'll be shining past the brightest light, just like gold, just like gold. Believing we can spark the break of dawn, we can find the power to be strong. Just let go, just let go.
We are in my washing bay and I took off the rims of the Porsche. Well, these rims really look terrible. I think they haven't been cleaned for years. And I wonder if I can get them totally clean. I don't think so, because they are really, really bad. Also, the inside of the rims are damaged. It's just corrosion, you know. This black stuff really eats up the rim. But, you know, I want to just look how far we can go with cleaning them. And it already looks better when I put them back on the car. So let's start and see if we can make something out of these rims. So, I'm going to let this stuff do its job, because it has to be on like for 10-15 minutes. Just let it soak and do its thing. Let's see if something came loose already. I think so. But again, there's no, I explained it already in another vlog, there's no solution or just one product that get all the pollution off, the dirt off. You have to work with more multiple products. This is kind of, well, this is really heavy stuff. And now when I'm going to rinse it off, I'm going to use also a tar remover because it's full of tar. And then, well, let's see how the rims look after this first cleaning. That was not so bad. Took already a lot off. Okay. Well, let's use some tar remover. Well, the Porsche is ready for the coating. Of course, when you clean the car with steam, it also decreases the paint. It takes everything off, especially when you you can see it when you clean the window with steam, and then you go over it with a towel. You notice that the towel is immediately stopping because it's so degreased that your towel just stops. The same thing on the paint when you clean the car with steam after you've been polishing, because I didn't want the car to be too wet. This kind of cars, you know, when it's wet, it goes everywhere and it's just not good. So with steam, you don't have really a lot of water, but you can still clean it perfectly. Of course, with new towels, never use used towels because you don't want any scratches or whatsoever. And after the steam cleaning, I of course did an IPA wipe down like 3 times. So I'm absolutely sure that this paint is ready for the coating. Well, I chose for the Mayvinci C16 coating because maybe in the future the owner is going to do some more respraying on this car. The edges on the door are damaged, and well, if you want to take the damage off, then you have to respray the whole door and also some parts of the rear fender, because otherwise you will see color differences. And you don't want that, especially on this color, you'll see everything. So I could also choose for the IAMO coating, but the IAMO coating is on too long, because when the owner thinks, hey, I'm going to respray it in 2 or 3 years, and the coating is on, well, it doesn't make sense. So I'm going for the midway. I could also choose for the MK4, but that's on for like 18 months, and that's maybe too short. So that's the reason why I'm going for the C16. And well, let's apply it and see what happens to the paint. She's already very glossy, and this is just the finishing touch. We'll be shining past the brightest light, just like gold, just like gold. Believing we can spark a break of time, we can find a path. So when I'm applying a coating, I always make sure that I do one panel at a time, so that's from the edge to the edge. And let's show you guys. Begin in the middle and go like this. I never stop. I'll show you what I mean by stopping in the middle, because otherwise you're just making sort of like a tsunami of coating, and then you're stopping and making like a sort of a pile up, and you don't want this. So it's crisscross, so I already did it like this, and now I'm going to do it from edge to edge. And I'm not doing like this and stop, otherwise you'll just have a very thick line of coating here. So from edge to edge, and don't stop. So you have to leave the coating on for a few minutes, and then when you look closely to the panel, you'll see that the coating is taking another appearance, and then it's time to get it off. So let's take it off with a microfiber towel. And again, I don't stop in the middle, otherwise you still have this pile up of coating. And then when the most of the coating is gone, then it's not so really important that you go from edge to edge. You can also make a circular motion, but that's a thing we don't want to use often. But it is possible, you know, because otherwise, sometimes when you do long strokes, you'll see something, you'll see some more coating, and you just have to go like this, you know, when I'm not putting any pressure. And always make sure that you use a light to check your work. You don't want to forget anything, otherwise when it's dry you have to polish it off and you have to do the section again. Going to coat the door, I always start in the middle and go up and down the whole door like this, and always only the door, you know, that's the only pedal you're going to coat. So up and down. And then I'm going from side to side to make sure I coated the whole door and don't forget anything. So that's the crisscross motion. Perfect. So after a few minutes, you'll see that the coating is taking another appearance on the door. You'll see that it's coming more visible, and that's the time to take it off. You don't want to take it to put it on too long, otherwise you have a problem with taking it off. So again, clean microfiber towel, and I'll always go from edge to edge. It doesn't matter if you hit the other part, because that's the section that still needs to be coated. And then go from edge to edge. And you'll feel that the coating is sort of like rough, you know, you feel that the towel is grabbing something. And then of course you can do the circular motion again. You don't want to do too much, but sometimes you just have to. Take the light, inspect your work. Make sure everything's gone. Well, this is okay.
voice in my head. Know me, call me, I will be restless. Somehow they chose me. This is my nightlife. Wanna be high life. I feel so reckless, calling them all night.
I'm calling, I'm calling, I'm calling.
It's the freedom I shouldn't have, with the people I shouldn't.
Bye.
you for watching Ride My Vlog. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a comment below the video and give a thumbs up. I'm going to try and answer all your questions. If you have any questions about Mayvinci, contact me or contact info@mayvinci.europe.com. If you want to be an installer or you just want more information about the coatings and the PPF. I'm going to get started on this Mercedes. A lot of work on that one, a lot of swirl scratches. I'm going to get it ready for the Mayvinci bodyguard so Yuri can do the installation of the whole front and some other parts of the car, but that's for the next vlog. Also the Fisker Karma, the end results you can see in the next vlog, so stay tuned for that one. Well, I hope to see you guys next time. Just stay tuned and bye-bye.